Okay, it's on.
Hey everybody, can you hear us? Say something fiendish.
Something fiendish.
Say something cooler.
How's it going out there?
Okay, great. They can hear all of us.
Okay, good. And we're just going to apologize now for what the video quality might be like. This is such a strain on my FPS, I had to turn my settings down a little bit.
We should probably do a blanket apology before we get started about all of the character names that we're going to butcher during the live stream.
Not me.
That's what everybody says. Anyway, it's time. Hello everyone to the DTC Roadshow. I'm Fiendish and I'm here today with Dimension Diva and our special guest Kula. Say hello.
Hello and hello. Thanks for having me.
And today this is a special off week episode. We're going to be looking at the entries from the 99 bottles of beer on the wall contest that Kula was a sponsor of. Before we get started, a little bit of news. The very last note on this week's patch notes: improve reliability of personal ground suppression mushrooms as well as intermittent lighting.
Woohoo!
Yeah. I just started a new build in Methosian Cascades. I haven't put any mushrooms down yet, so here's hoping that they work. I looked in some of the ones I have mushrooms already active, and just as a personal anecdotal thing, They've been a lot more stable and working much better. Along with that, also, they tried to make the Sanctuary of Rebirth and the Stonefield Chapel act like regular buildings now, to where they would react to light effects and time of day and things like that, which they normally would not react to prior to this fix.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, so with this contest ending, there's another one that's still going on. You want to talk about that one, Diva?
Sure, it's the North American Morph Madness Contest, and you can read all about it on the forums. Really excited to see a morphing contest, so hope everybody will give it a whirl.
Yeah, and that one has actually been opened up worldwide now.
That's right. A few prizes will be awarded on North American shards only, so European winners will have to pick those up there. But otherwise, everybody can build on their home shard where their mighty hordes reside. So that's good news.
Yes, it is. And also, Soul Shield on the forums is giving away glass and water building blocks. So if you're on EU, because this is an EU only thing, I highly suggest you go to the forums and put your name at Shard in. Otherwise, he's going to destroy them. And I just can't.
That would be bad. Yes.
So we're going to go ahead and get started. Right now we're on the French language server of Brissisol, and we're just going down the weekly. So this is the last pub before is the name of the entry, and it's by Arwen. I really like this one.
Me too.
Me three.
Now is this...
I wanted to say...
Go ahead.
Oh, I'm sorry, Fiendish. I just got to say I love the puking guy here. Because that'd be me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I can't think of, you know, a couple too many things I would rather do if the end of the world is imminent, which it is here, than just
might drink.
As well, yep, might as well just go out happy.
Get those new mushrooms.
Yeah. I really like the
I love this drainage system.
Yeah. That and all his crumbled and burning buildings and the context that he added.
Yeah. So much great detail around that.
I think it's pretty cool when you come in and it's a little cityscape.
I agree. Now, is this is the first dimension contest you've run, isn't it?
That's correct. How many have you run?
I don't know. How many have we run? It's been a lot.
Well, we've run a couple, but you've run a lot more.
No, I'm not going to count, but are there 99 bottles of beer on that wall?
Uh-oh.
Possibly. I was just looking at
these
bottles.
That's too much counting.
Because one really great detail that he added here was to make the bottles different. And even, you know, these are pretty simple morphs, but still, you know, it's a great... it's attention to what's going on, that they're not all exactly the same. I really like that. And this...
Yeah, I love those labels. Yeah, great detail.
Yeah, I like those trophy mounts on the wall, too.
Yep. And here we've got our first dancing NPC.
First drink.
Yeah, I've got some errands to run today, so I'm not going to be able to to play the Roadshow drinking game, which was going to be to take a drink for every dancing NPC.
Well, crap!
Yeah.
I don't think you'd make it out.
No.
Here I am with these six hurricanes, what am I going to do?
Well, you can play the Roadshow drinking game. There should probably be a shot for every new
game. Yes, we are.
And a double shot if we find one that has more than four Nikos in it. I know of at least one.
I like the little taps here, too. That's pretty cool.
Yes.
Oh, and we should say that you guys know this, but we're going to be going through 21 dimensions. I think that's right. And so, you know, we can't do them the justice that they all deserve during one live stream. So, you know, we're going to take quick looks at these wonderful dimensions.
Yes.
So as I would just urge everybody, come for a first-hand look if you haven't already done so. They really need to be seen in person anyway. But, you know, we're going to miss a lot of good details today.
For sure. And a lot of the entrants posted ads and blurbs with their builds. And comparing the ad to the dimension itself, there's a lot of them that really follow their storylines close. I like that.
Yeah, I really enjoyed getting to read the blurbs for each one.
That was a good idea.
That was a good idea, Kula.
Yep, so we're going to the next one, which is a tier one. We're not going to go by separate tiers either. They're just going to go by shards. The next one is Fuyo, and it's a tier one, Edgestone Ridge, the Faraway Tavern. I am just going to say, I think Arwen did a great job with that one. He's somebody I like to call the professional contestants, and I mean that in a good way. So it was good to see him join this contest, too.
She means people who support all the contests by participating in them. It's just awesome.
Now, I had a question for you. Has either one of you entered anything into the morphing contest?
No, I haven't yet.
I haven't decided yet what I want to do. Morphine.
Okay, here it comes. Here it comes. She's going to say that she's not comfortable morphing or something like that. And then she makes Pleasant Valley, which is filled with adorable and wonderful morphs. So Just don't go there, Fiendish.
All right, I won't. Thanks for taking the wind out of my sails. Thank you.
Always here to help.
I like the wood slats. Not to change the subject, but I like the wood slats here on this wall. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Oh, I love this wall too.
Entry lattice is. It's pretty awesome.
It is incredible.
Yeah, I have bad memories of being in my cottage trying to mess with those and spending about 4 hours, so I can appreciate the work.
Yeah, Fuyo also had an entry into Cozy Cottages, and this was really good. I've looked him up. I don't know if he's an alt or has an alt that he also builds under, but he's got... And I'm making the assumption that it's a he. That's a horrible habit I have. He's got 3 builds on Brisasol, and all of them are really worth checking out. So, I love this furniture in the private lounge made from tavern kegs.
And that's always a fun way to tour, like you're saying, Fiendish, is... Like for the contests, if you're going to go and visit, you know, contests on a specific server, look up the other dimensions that those builders may have, because you can really find some awesome stuff to tour that way, too.
Oh, yeah.
I kind of like how this little fireplace is kind of tucked in here, sort of a custom.
Yeah, it's great. I love the rock there. It's really cool.
That and that that big aquarium back there, that's a nice touch of color.
Really pretty.
And this is a full service bar. We've got the restaurant part here. And here's Diva's facilities.
Did you go upstairs?
Yeah, I went upstairs already.
Hey now!
What? You're the one with the bathroom fixation.
I can't find the bathroom.
It's Mark WC.
It's
part of the water
inside
closet.
The lattice room.
Well, I'm a guy, so I'll just go outside.
There are a lot of bushes out there.
Yep.
But that would be a shame. This is
nice
really
little
beautiful.
Patio area.
It is. Fuyo did a good job here of incorporating some elements of the base dimension. And Edgestone Ridge is a place where you don't see a lot of anyways.
Yeah, we got to see a pretty big variety of base dimensions used for the contest. I like that.
Mm-hmm. And there was no item limit. The only thing was the separation of tiers by the capacity.
I like that feature of your contest, Kula.
Well, thank you. And I just wanted to say, there are a lot of contests where you feel like it's a little bit unfair when somebody has a 25-20 and then somebody uses a 15-20 and you go, well, you can get so much more detail in the bigger one. So I thought maybe I'll break it up. And along with some of the other lessons I learned, but I thought that was a good feature.
I agree.
Yep. I've moved on to Guerre de la Coule by Errol. And Errol has a lot of dimensions on Brissol, and they're all train stations. Now, she's gone on the forums and posted a big map of how they're all linked together and the different zones that they represent. So, I mean, as far as that kind of factor, we're blending in lore and exploration and dimension building all in one. I really like that aspect.
This is a builder. It's really fun to come over and do a tour of, you know, all of their builds.
Yeah, I think she said this is the 13th train station.
Wow, I didn't realize that.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Oh, is she the one that had the map?
Yes.
Yes.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah, and you
I don't know where you guys
to,
are.
To check all the little nooks and crannies. I mounted. I normally don't mount in a dimension, but this isn't anywhere, and Errol's pretty much using boundary to boundary on this thing, so just for the sake of speed, I'm mounted in here when I normally don't.
I'm going to get run over by a train. Oh, there you are. Thank goodness you came and found me, Diva.
Now, the winner announcement on this is going to come out Wednesday, right? Well, by Wednesday.
Yes, it will come out. It'll come out by Wednesday or before. As you know, there's a lot of, when you start really digging into these things, really the amount of detail, for me personally, I like to slow down and just take note of everything.
Diva, you didn't tell me my UI was still on.
And if you wanted me to just tell you real quick, you didn't ask me, but we had kind of like the ratings broken down by technical quality, creativity, theme, and within those things there are some variations, like for example proportion, specificity, details, any morphing, originality, construction, the theme, the mood, that type of thing. So it's really hard to judge, truly, but you got to start somewhere.
Yeah, I would agree. Dimension judging can be pretty highly subjective.
Kind of one of the things I was thinking after the fact, and it's always easier in hindsight, but I was thinking the better details that you put on the front of your contest, the easier it is pretty much for everybody. And sometimes, I know initially I was a little loose with my parameters, but the more detailed you can be is definitely better.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Me too.
Kind of makes it easier for the builder too. I'm following somebody.
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, that's you, Fiendish. I don't like playing on train tracks, you know.
Yeah, it's dangerous.
It was fun getting to see some of the new architect dimension items being used in the contest, too.
Yeah, some of them made some appearances in really interesting ways.
There's just so much detail about everything in here. I mean, look at the train wheels and, you know, various parts on the wheels.
Yeah, and Errol's always really good about them. The connecting lines and the lights and then showing track switching and things like that.
Oh yes, I just love the track switching. You know, I got really lucky when I came over to look at this contest dimension one day because Errol was over here and came in and gave me a tour and chatted with me for a long time, so that's always wonderful when you can talk to the builder, you know, when you're touring. I just encourage people to just look for them if you're going over touring.
Well, when you get into Fablight, we're going to have people in their dimensions.
Okay, great.
Cool.
And I asked them that they all needed to take their clothes off.
Okay.
As a prerequisite. No, I just made that.
Oh, great. Up, now Fiendish is going to change into one of her other outfits.
Well.
All right. So now we're going to head off to Broodwalk. If you head over to Braces Hall, make sure you explore Gare de la Cool and check all of the nooks and crannies, because I know there's something, stuff that we missed, because there's a secondary path down to the bottom.
Oh yeah, we missed a ton in here. Definitely come and have time to explore.
Yep, so I'm going to head over to Broodwalk. Do you want to do a giveaway, Diva?
Sure. So let's see, we've got some different things to give away today. Let's give away one of these Helms of the Demon Lord to make sure that our giveaway system is going to work for us today.
this would be the time I'm on a long 95% loading screen.
Now this is the ice one, right? Oh yeah.
Yeah, I just got in.
Cool. Yeah, this one I think from the outside.
Well, the first one on the weekly is Tercer's.
Oh, whoops.
Yep, Fort Zarno's Beach.
Let me get on the same page.
Yeah, we're just going down the weekly because that's the easiest way to do it.
It's hard for me to follow along. I've already had like 5 drinks.
Well, the train station was a double shot because I think there were 5 Nikos in there.
All right, this is the floating ship.
Yeah, the Flying Tavern, I think, is the English translation. If that's not, then that's pretty close.
After 3 beers, it doesn't matter.
And this is just, I'm gonna run around the underside and the bottom a little bit before we go up there, because, wow. I certainly wouldn't have the patience to try to do something like this. I think it was fantastic way that he used the windmills as propellers.
I mean, this flying ship looks awesome from the outside, and when you get inside and you can see how those curved walls are built, oh boy. It's really amazing.
Yeah, I like that too. And I thought, I mean, obviously he had using the little entry point the way he did was good.
Okay, so here's how our giveaways are going to work today. I need everybody to type exclamation point DTC into chat, and that will make you eligible for the prizes. Like I just demonstrated. I think lowercase, uppercase doesn't matter.
Okay, I've taken the PvP port. I'm up on the ship now. And one thing I really liked about this build was that not only is it a flying tavern, but the rooms are open so you can go inside and explore. Love these sails.
Okay, so Lyrial Moon has won this first giveaway for a helm of the Demon Lord, and congratulations.
Congrats.
Good job.
No drinking on the job, Kula.
They tell me that all the time. I better go in the kitchen here and sober up.
Orfeel Farrowwind is in here creating havoc.
Oh, yeah. I like that guy.
Yeah, you never know what he's going to do.
You know what's also cool on this one is, I mean, this guy could get away with just having one floor, but there's another floor below, which is just more work to do, but cool. Cool detail.
Definitely.
And there's a nice big bed down here to crash out on.
Crash out or pass out?
Yes.
Right.
Both. Actually, there's a couple of them.
Mm-hmm. I just got changed into a thing.
Yep, that's it. That Orfeel guy. There were a lot of glass and water blocks used in this contest, too.
Lots of different uses. It's obvious those are going to be favorite items.
Yep, and there have been numerous requests on the forums for the devs to make those available all the time. If you support it, I guess show your support on that on the thread. And there's a new thread up to bring back some of the common and uncommon items to Stan's lure table. Because now you've got items that are graded as common and they're like the rarest thing in the game.
Hey, so I got a question for you, Fiendish.
Mm-hmm.
So you have over 57 dimensions that you built, but you put on your website your personal favorite is Black Flower Shrine. I just was wondering why.
At the time, it was the hardest thing I'd ever built. It's a very technical dimension. I tried to incorporate some Hindu architecture, and that I just like it. There's, you know, it's old now, and it needs to be fixed now that we've got some tools to make it better. Because at the time I built it, we didn't have dream weaving, we didn't have indicators, we didn't, you know, I did it with toolbox. But I don't know, I haven't had the heart to tear it down to rebuild it. That was kind of unexpected.
Well, I actually read
good job, Kula.
What about you, Diva? What's your favorite personal dimension?
Oh, I don't know. My favorite is usually the one I'm working on now, and I'm a really weird, secretive builder, so... I love the surprise factor myself. I love when someone keeps their dimension secret, or I don't get a look at it, and then I go and see it when it's finished. That's just a favorite thing of mine, which is one of the reasons why I love contests so much. It's like Christmas Day when suddenly there are, you know, 10 or 20 or even 30 new dimensions that I've never seen before, and I get to go see them. But it's hard to have favorites of mine. I tend to go in and see, you know, the problems that I missed, so.
I totally understand. And it's funny how when you build something and you think it's perfect, and then you get a little bit of time between when you finished it and you go back and go, man, what was I thinking there? Why did I do that?
That's so true. The passage of time really does that.
Yep. And now we're in Nightclub on Ice by Chulia.
The thing I think is cool about this is it, from the outside, it's just such a cool-looking, different building structure.
Yeah.
And
oh, it's
obviously
spectacular.
You can tell those stairs are just awesome-looking.
The architecture here is extremely unique. And all of these ice cubes, I just could not imagine... using all these ice cubes.
I don't know how they keep the water flowing in this place.
I think the other night when we were in here, we were talking about how it's almost like somewhere out in space, like a moon thing, because there's nothing around it to distract from the architecture.
Right. It'd be like
I hadn't had that
in a sci-fi movie.
Yes, I hadn't had that thought, but when you say that, yes. Totally true.
Well, I'm having a hell of a time up these stairs. Okay.
Yep.
Don't go up, I'm drunk. Or maybe go down them drunk.
Well, going down would be a lot faster than going up either way. And if you're drunk, you
tuck and roll
it till tomorrow. But Julia is always going to come up with some pretty awesome architecture, and this is definitely no exception. So, for your first contest, are you pretty satisfied with how this one came out, like as far as the number and the quality of the entries?
Yeah, definitely. You're always a little nervous at first when you kick it off and you're waiting to see who enters, and it gained momentum slowly, but yeah, I think it's cool. It was fun, had a lot of good feedback, so definitely.
That's great.
Well, you also had a shorter window than most contests do with that 1 month building period, and that actually did seem to work out pretty well for you. Wow, just. Wow, good job, Julia.
Yeah, this one too is going to be one where people end up coming in and doing some RP.
Oh, I'm sure.
Which, you know, I never really give too much thought to that until you start looking at different dimensions and go, okay, this one's sort of a picturesque type project, and then some of them are definitely more suited for RP.
Now, I know you're on Fablight. Do you RP, or is that not something that you really participate in?
Oh, I usually get myself into some kind of trouble.
Hey, I'm heading into rashness.
I'd say I dabble in it a little bit, but it's definitely not my favorite thing. Off to the Bell and Crown?
Yep, we're on the Bell
yes.
and Crown, which if you read Rashna's advertisement for this, it's right outside Canterbury Cathedral. And closing time is 10 p.m.
I think I fell through the floor.
Yeah, you might have to exit and re-enter. Now, Rashna, if you haven't headed to Brute Walked and looked at Arashna's dimensions in person, I cannot encourage that enough. She does some just amazing, amazing things. The Tyrannosaurus immediately jumps to mind. And Wall-E and Hocus Pocus and...
I keep falling through the floor.
But in this one, I'm really surprised I didn't get the police called on me because I kept trying to break into the windows.
I know, I wanted in there so badly.
It sure does add an element to it when there's things you want to get into and you can't.
Yeah, it's a very unexpected concept. But I know all this brickwork out here is just, wow.
So much detail in that, it's just amazing. Can't imagine how and much this time
Oh, I'm sure it took just ages to do. And this lettering on the bar name... this is something with this contest. There are a couple of people who really did some amazing lettering. And it's hard. Hard to do.
Yep, we got a private party going on upstairs. But one thing I did like is that even though you can't get into the interior, it's fully fleshed out so you can see it.
Yeah.
Look around.
All right, so I got a question for you two.
Okay.
What's your favorite alcoholic drink?
Oh boy.
See, I come up with some good ones. Everybody wants to know.
I'm pretty bland. I got in the habit of vodka and Red Bull when I lived in Germany.
Wow!
Oh, there's got to be some stories there.
No?
Why am I not surprised?
Not that you remember.
What happens in Germany stays in Germany.
That's exactly right.
What about you, Diva? What's your favorite drink?
Cuba Libre.
You gotta tell me what that is.
Rum and Coke.
Oh. Alright.
And a lot of lime. But I'd never turn down a Sapporo.
Alright. It's about time to head to NA. This was the last one on EU. We want to do another giveaway, Diva?
Sure, let's give away one of our snails.
Awesome.
But only if you want a chance to win the snail. If you don't care about the snail mount, don't type it in there.
Unless you want to give it to me.
You're trying to keep mine.
I'd interpret that as sell. Sell to her.
I don't think I could afford it.
So going to Lathis?
Yep, we're going to Lathis.
And we had one entry in Lathis. I don't know if I'm saying that right. But it was Valen.
Yep, it's called the Hawk.
Exclamation point DTC.
Who's going to win?
Oh, and by the way, we forgot to mention this, but... usually our guests are eligible to win, but since you won one last time, Kula, we're going to remove that for this
what?
Show.
Oh, that's all good.
Unless you want to give it to me.
I did win one, so yeah. And it's pretty cool.
We're in the hunt right
okay,
now.
Okay, it looks...
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Looks like everybody has... I just wish I could fish off of it.
So I'm going to roll now. Sorry, keep going with the tour. Nightbot is having a hiccup.
Okay, well...
Okay.
Before we go in, I really love the use of the icicles to make this lettering.
I agree. That's pretty cool.
It is cool, and it, if you think of what the haunt might mean, then that, the way that the icicles run down definitely fits that vibe. And we got some architect pillars. Kind of blended into the existing area of Harrow Crypt. And there were a couple of Harrow Crypts used in this contest too, which I was actually kind of glad to see. I really like Harrow Crypt, and you don't see it very often. I gotta get me one of these guys.
And I can't remember,
sign.
Oh yeah, that's good. I think we own... How many stone tasks, Flavern? Stone... See, I can't talk.
Stone flask?
I need another drink. Yeah, whatever you call it. I think there were like one in there we had, or two maybe, but...
I think it was only one. Three springs, yeah. There were a couple, but I think there was only one stone
right.
flask, and they did not use the tavern.
Yeah, which we were talking about the other day. That was... You know, like we said, the expectation on this would be there would be a bunch of tavern entries, but everybody was there's a good variety, so that was cool.
There is.
Okay, guys, in the interest of fairness, Nightbot had to be reloaded, and while it's embarrassing for me to tell you this, I'm telling you, type DTC, exclamation point DTC again, because it all had to be reloaded. And I would rather make the roll be fair and look like a Nightbot doofus. So, type it again, please, if you want to win a snail mount. Thank you all so much.
I like when you look up on the top of this one where there's the dragon head or whatever that thing is poking through there. That looks pretty cool.
Yep. He's got a lot of interesting ceiling detail. I like the use of the glumwood walls here to make this structure. Kalari staircases.
Yeah, these this inside of here has so much a little contrast and variety that it's actually kind of fun to look around.
Yeah,
I thought that was neat.
Yeah, he's got some cool wall art going on.
And the winner of the first snail mount is Z-Mage. Congratulations,
Z-Mage.
Oh,
good
congrats.
Job.
Now, once we finish, I'll be sending those codes out via instant message over Twitch. Unless it's like the Corvin bags, and then we'll need a name at Shard, so we know who to gift those to.
You might have to ask her twice.
Yeah, if Twitch ends up having a problem where it doesn't send the message, you can PM me over the forums or however. And we'll get you the code another way.
Yeah, I never did get any messages on that.
That's really weird.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Oh, we don't want to go down that way.
That's the way it goes.
Oh, well, you're sliming Talara with your snail mount, so it worked out.
Sliming it all over. If I could fish off of that thing, I'd never get off. I tried to at first. I thought, can I fish off of this thing? I think in WoW you could fish off of a couple mounts, if I remember.
I don't know about that one.
I can't remember. Maybe I was just making it up.
I really liked the way he used these, the Rinky Thrones to make his bar, too. That bar centerpiece, because that's really, really a dramatic thing.
I'd like to steal
it's
these
super
camels.
Cool.
Yeah, and you know, how long has it been since you've seen a fire sky in use?
No, that's a good use of it.
Yeah, I know just for myself, it's been quite a while since I've seen a fire sky projector in a new build.
I haven't used it since I burned Uncle Stan at the stake.
Yeah. I mean, I like the fires. We used to use the fire sky because it would stop weather effects, and it was the only one that we had that would. You try to stack it with the
love all
one.
The little rooms.
Yeah, I'm heading back to the hidden area now, and this was a hidden area I actually found. I feel pretty proud of myself over that one.
Yeah, it goes further back than you think.
Yep.
I'm going to come back there and throw up.
Wow.
Hey, the DTC's not paying any cleanup fees associated with this live stream.
Yeah, one thing I do like about this one is he put a damaged thing back here by this plant heart. Ooh. I think that was a pretty neat thing. Are you going to kill yourself?
One way or the other.
Well, don't do that.
No, this guy's tough.
Fun, creative stuff in here.
Yeah, this has a good feel to it. You know, some of them have different, kind of a different feeling or theme or impression, and this one has a cool one. Good place for a cold one.
Yes, it is. Did he have a blurb with this one? I thought he did.
Let me check that real quick. That's a good question. Hang on.
And again, I'm making the assumption that it's a he. I'm not. I don't know if it is or not. Do you like these little cutouts that he made, though?
Well, the haunt says, drink till you drop. Happy hour welcomes the happy undead. So. Short and sweet.
Fair enough. There's a lot of nice architectural touches in here, too. A lot of the new architect stuff, like these walls. And there's a teleportation base making that white spinny thing. Pretty good what you can do with 1,200 items. Alright, and we're off now to Hylal. maybe.
We're on our way.
Yeah, well.
Three entries on this one.
Some more fantastic lettering on some of these. It makes me even more ashamed of my sad attempts at lettering.
Yep, first one on the list is by Mava, the Angry Orchard. And Mava is an alt
Angry
of Nuve, who runs the Dimension Gallery site.
Cool.
And this is our
which I'm happy to see is going strong.
Yep, and this is the second Harrow Crypt build with a much different vibe. Love these morphed apple trees.
I like how this place is a little bit over the water. That's pretty neat.
Yep.
You going back to the apple orchard?
Yep, we're going around the outside and then we'll head in inside.
Not to change the subject, but I do think it's really cool how you guys keep your website updated. I always hate to go see some that are 2-3 years before the last time somebody's done an update. So keeping it fresh.
Thank you. There is some stuff that we have on there that's out of date. It's on my to-do list. I have a whole bunch of stuff on the to-do list.
Oh yeah.
Love that apple face up there with the sad frown.
Definitely.
Oh yes, the angry apple is just adorable. Wonderful.
And these little picture
morph. Well, I found Nico.
Yep. Little picture morph here with the goblet banners.
Yeah, those are cool.
Great use of those.
Those and the market stalls that are up on the second floor for curtains. This jukebox here is pretty cute.
Oh, I love the little jukebox.
Yep.
Oh, you beat me too.
Very creative.
And I like what she did with the crafting stations here. Like this dunking barrel.
Yeah, that's cool. I'm going to try to get an apple out of there.
And then again with the dream focus and making it into a vat. And then displays here. This is very much seems like a little place you would run into out in the country.
Yep, for sure. It definitely has that feel. Apple pie and apple wine.
All at once.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay, so now our next stop is Plaza Orantine, and it's Fiorinelli on the wall. And Farinelli actually wrote a pretty long story about playing cards and devastation outside and like what happened to the last person that tried to rip off the bar. One thing I do like about this one, this is a pretty enclosed interior build, but there is a view of the outside that shows you the devastation that Farinelli wrote about in her blurb.
Yeah, that was cool. I'm glad people added that part of it to their, you know, to the contest.
Yeah, I
can't read this one, though. It's too long.
Yeah, well, I read it, and it actually matches almost exactly the story that she's telling with the actual build.
Yeah, that's cool. That makes it fun.
Yeah, I really like this intro.
And she's here!
Hey! AFK. Oh. I really like seeing that there was a Plaza Orantine submitted in this.
There's the last thief up there.
Yeah, I like that. I got a chuckle out of that.
I love the different decor in these different seating nooks.
Yep, those were also talked about in the blurb, was the different types of seating areas. And one thing that really stood out to me was, if you look at the tables, all the table decoration is different. None of the table, well, yeah. I mean, a couple of them are the same, but most of them are not exactly the same. I think that's a great attention to detail.
Nice little variety.
Mm-hmm. Really like this fish tank back here, too.
Yeah, very pretty. Using the vertical space so well in here too.
Yes. And covering up the flame fans. I love this Now, she wrote on her blurb about the card games, and it was some kind of try something cards. So that was a great way to add some context to using the triangles to make cards.
Right. Card game of triumph for a few pouches of gold dust.
Yep. So we've got our pouches of gold dust here and the cards. I mean, this, I really, really like the way this one matched the descriptive paragraph chapter.
Yes, and there's a bathroom up here.
Yep, here's another little toilet for you, Diva.
I'm busy now trying to break into the wine room.
Oh, yeah. Did you
get
in?
Love this feature. Not yet.
And, I like this little morphed hat that she made on the rack before we leave here. I just want to say I like that little detail, the hang in your hat.
Yeah, that's cool. A lot of times it's the little things in these, even these big places.
Yep.
That's true. Really well done.
And our last stop on Hylol is Bucket of Blood by Maeve.
Oh, that's a nice machine there, Fiendish.
Yeah, but it's not a snail mount. And again, with Maeve, she's got so much exterior stuff going on out here. I'm just going to mount up for the sake of being a little bit faster. There's a whole lot of background stuff that she added here. I'm jealous over all these cows.
I'm just trying to find the bar. Oh, here it is. I'm going to be really thirsty after all this running. I don't know what happened in here.
This little fountain from the cannon is really cute. He's got the little deer.
Looks like you can get fish stew.
Yep.
Boy, with Orfeel as a bartender, I bet you can get a really good flaming Dr. Pepper.
Possibly.
This one has just a ton of spaces to explore, inside and outside.
Yes, it does. It looks like some of the guests got a little bit rowdy.
I tabbed out to see if there was a
so
something, a description or something, but there's not.
Yep. Now the description was something that was optional, right? It did not have to be included.
Right. It was just optional, just to add another dynamic to it.
I think it's a really fun feature of this contest. And I like it too. Sometimes people on the forums, when they do a post about a new build, they'll include a little story in there too. I really like getting to read the stories.
Yep, same here. And Maeve did a lot of work in this kitchen. There's a lot of details in here I really like. The stove is really cool. And this little mixing table made from the boggling stumps.
You know, it's kind of funny, after the cottages contest, I was kind of looking forward to something else. And I was talking to some people about it, and we were like, yeah, you know, it'd be cool. Because All the time you're building houses and things like that. So I don't remember how we came up with the idea, but we thought, hey, it'd be cool to build like a little tavern. It's a little bit different, or something, whatever. So that's kind of what the whole idea was triggered from.
Yeah, well, there Rift ran a big contest in 2014. It was called the Dream Destination Contest, and that was all bars. It was a bar contest too. But I mean, there's nothing that says that you can only run something one time.
Is a really good theme.
Yeah, I think the tavern and places dedicated to drinking was a really good idea.
Thanks. Yeah, I didn't know that there was another one, so that's interesting.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a while. Usually once a year or so, Tryon will either run a big dimension contest or they'll team up with one of the fan sites and run it. Or let the fan site run it.
Did you hop into a different dimension?
No, I'm upstairs.
Oh. Oops. I didn't make it up there. I was looking for Nico.
I don't remember seeing a Nico in this one.
Here you are.
It's okay, you can just take a shot for no rhyme or reason.
Done. You and your eclectic drinks, Diva.
So definitely
this has got a lot of rooms in it.
Yeah, it does. They added a lot of stuff upstairs, downstairs, outside. This whole place is really you got to explore it.
Yep.
But for right now, we are off to Wolfsbane. Now, who do we know that had an entry on Wolfsbane? Who could that have been?
I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't know either. Dimension Mojo, who could that be?
It's a mystery.
It is.
All right.
I think since we're in your dimension, we should give away the 5 Corvin bags.
There you go.
Okay.
And you have to tell me what made you decide on a biker bar.
I just was trying to think of something amusing, which is kind of my goal with all my dimensions. And I thought I could make a biker bar and have some torn up tables, and then I got to thinking, how can I make a biker bar extra? Or how can I make it funny? And I thought, I bet no one would think of a dwarf biker bar.
I'm not even gonna... I love this chopper.
Yeah, these choppers are cool.
Thank you.
But that must have taken a lot of work.
There's one that's they might be looking at a beatdown.
You got your eye on that crotch rocket, Fiendish?
Yep.
well, there's not much here besides the motorcycles and the dwarves, so, Kula, you said those look like they took time. You know, I pretty much had to spend time making those because there's not much else here.
Well, there's a lot in here, though. And the bathroom's on fire. Probably my fault.
Oh, this big mural on the wall. I like both the murals.
Yeah, that's awesome. I like how you made the girl back here washing dishes and you used vases to make the outfit. Pretty creative.
Well, you know, with those particular vases, when I very first walked in here, I instantly thought of the Fembots off of Austin Powers.
Right.
Pew, pew, pew.
Okay, so let's do another giveaway. Hey, everybody, type exclamation point DTC again.
Yep, and this one's for 5 Corbin bags. So we'll need a name at Shard, too.
And this guy's passed out. And I love how this bike's speeding off into the nowhere. I actually tried to run in there.
Yeah, good old anywhere, you gotta block off all access to get beyond the build, so.
Well, it's so good from a depth perspective to have how you did the road around in there. And again, that's a small kind of silly thing because everything else is so great, but it's cool. It adds that layer. Lots of cool stuff to look at. My favorite thing too, not my favorite thing, but I like how you got the trash can back here. I don't know if you already mentioned that.
Oh, the dumpster? I didn't say anything
the
about
dumpster.
It. The dumpster.
You gotta have little details like that.
And the winner is Tiesa.
Congratulations.
Okay, what's the name and shard on that one?
Hey, Tiesa 2016. Will you tell us your character name and shard? Oh, okay, so it's TS at Fablite. We should have been able to guess that.
T-I-E.
And when I say we, I mean... That is correct.
Yes.
Okay. I mean, Saturday
Thank
night.
You.
Great job on this one. You know, I have not built anything in Tulan yet.
I haven't either. I'm going to leave and come back in.
You know, I love this satyr that greets you at the front entrance. And in fact, I used a screenshot of this when I sent out the tweet today about our live stream.
That's right.
Okay, well, it's going to take a while to kick
Kula's
in.
Kula's getting his freak on.
I see that. I like the way that they made this into a very high-lol kind of place. Not the dimension, but the zone. You can recognize it with Atrophinius down here. And then the critters that are here and there.
All the pretty fun areas to explore in here.
I heard you guys talking about that on one of your other shows, where sometimes these dimensions you go in and you don't really recognize which one it is, which is actually kind of a cool thing.
Yeah. I love that when I have to look at the dimension name to tell where I am.
Yep.
It's awesome.
Yep, we did a contest about that. What was it, 2 years ago? Something like that?
Yep.
You guys working on any new contest ideas?
Well, we always have ideas. It just depends on how much money we, you know, feel like coming up with to shell out the prizes.
Oh no, don't remind me of that. That may have been one oversight on my part.
Well, I mean, there was a contest a while back. We paid out, 26 recs? I mean, that's too much to do very often.
Oh, yeah.
Blythe says we need a contest that Fiendish will enter.
No, I don't do well with contests. Really like this bar setup.
Oh, it's so pretty.
I love how with the glass tiles you can do these subfloors. That's a fun thing.
Yeah. Instead of
definitely
stacking up invisible tiles. And then no one will walk
exactly on
them because they can't see the invisible tiles.
Right. I must have missed Nico.
I didn't think she had a Nico in here.
Ah, okay.
So you're out of luck.
No, he got the day off from here.
Oh, that's no problem. We've got a visitor in here.
Well, that's good.
Hey, Blythe, I see your text. I set up two computers so I can kind of read the text that's coming through. Kind of glancing over at it.
Okay. We got this nice little area over here.
I mean, this one has a really kind of defined color scheme. And I really like that. And it's interesting to see some of the, you know, items from, like, different events or different, you know, whatever, sources that utilize these colors and work so well together, like the carnival lights and, you know, all the halal trees and
the Summerfest hedges.
Yeah, all the Summerfest hedges, right.
And even some of the,
you know, Nightmare Tide. Oh, yeah, that too. And some of the Nightmare Tide, you know, coral, water plane stuff.
Yep. Now we're off to Fablite. We're going to hit Greybriar last because it's my chart, and, you know, she who runs the camera sets the rules.
Well, Mrs. School is home. Fablite.
Yep.
That's right. Where I can do all my RP.
And of course I turned my UI off before bringing the weekly up. So the first one on Fablite's weekly is Margaritaville.
And I had a song ready for this one.
No singing. We don't let Aflac sing, oh. So we can't let anyone sing. Oh.
Yeah, no. Don't worry, I wasn't going to sing. All right. I think my first impression on this one when I came in was just how you can see this whole thing open up and really gives you a feeling of going to a bar or a beach bar and just chilling out.
Yes, it's very, very detail-oriented.
Oh, this one is just a blast to explore. Love it.
Yeah, love that parrot.
Oh, I have a special outfit for this one, too.
All these tiki details just are so wonderful.
Can you get a picture of me?
Yeah, but you gotta go stand in the shark thing. Because that's what that's
all right,
what
I'm heading that way. I may not make it out of this one.
Smart, say cheese.
Oh my god, I got it. It's so awesome. You know we gotta post this.
Yes.
That is fantastic. And I mean, making the shark bait thing that Blythe made, I mean, how creative is that? It's awesome.
Yeah, that's a great idea. And I like the band setup, too.
I wish I hadn't hidden my Yui, because then the screenshot would have captured Kula saying, cheese!
We got the mixing board. There's like bowls of peanuts and popcorn, including like little slivers that have fallen on the floor.
Very good detail.
Yeah, this is a real, like I said, this is a real detail-oriented place.
Did you come back here for a hamburger too?
Not yet. I'm heading back behind the bar now.
Well, get in here for a burger. It's ready.
Okay. I'm not going to let it get cold. I like the fish above the bar with each of them has their own special little drink. And then the chalkboard specials.
You don't have to say drink twice to me.
Yep. And then
love the details on the chalkboard.
Yeah, and the POS system. I'm going to guess that Blythe has watched a couple episodes of Bar Rescue.
Well, I imagine.
Then all
I
the
like
little,
using the little boats there.
Yeah.
The netting.
The fryer baskets really got me with waffle fries.
Yep. And the spritzer bottles.
Fish.
Yeah, crazy detail in here.
Yeah, Blythe did a lot of detail.
What was that, Kula?
I just think it's so cool how there's the whole outward feeling, tone, and then this all the little fine details in here. Well, very well done.
mean, don't you want to party here?
She could probably rent this place out, because the role players are going to have this as a haven.
Well, I want some key lime pie.
Where's the bathroom?
Oh, right, back over here near where you come in.
Oh, perfect. I always got to find that first before I start drinking.
Yeah, because once you break the seal, it's done.
Well, I guess there's a pool, so...
Ooh!
We could just take a swim.
And the Ahoy mural there. I mean, that's so fantastic.
You may not be allowed to come back, Kula.
Yeah, I went from a blue pool to a green one. Yeah, that mural up there is awesome. Very well done, Blythe.
Yes, well done. The next stop is going to be Vuka Bar. I'm going to exit and then enter.
Oh yeah, I had a song for this one too. But due to copyright restrictions, I was unable to bring that. Love this little place. This is awesome.
Yes, this is another one that's real detail-oriented.
Beautiful.
And it's also an interior-only build.
Right away, I just want to point out the VUCA lettering is masterful. I mean...
Made from windows.
Perfect in this theme.
You know, I talked to Vu, and she said this was her second build. And the same with Blight, which is amazing.
It is.
I think Vu's first build was for the Cozy Cottages 2 contest.
Yeah, both of them were.
Yep.
I really enjoyed this this little seating canopy over here.
Yeah, I love this sunken area.
Oh, it's so, so good. One day, Vu and I were trying to think of the architectural name for this, what you called this little seating canopy. But, you know, little time with the hookah and the memory does not do well.
I already passed out.
Yep, there he is. Sleeping on the job now.
I think I smoked the wrong thing. Yeah, the details in here are awesome. This is such a fun one. This is going to be another one that's going to be a role player haven. I can't get into the bathroom, though.
I do like this, the way she did this doorway here, with the music boxes and the chains.
Yeah, it's really cool.
I like the way these windows are framed.
Mm-hmm.
With the block. That's a unique shape to use those blocks for, which is actually really cool. And then using those cages. And this light over here.
Mm-hmm. I like the display here of the different tobaccos.
Tobaccos?
Yes, that's what you have to call them.
Oh, I thought it was something else.
And those little wine glasses that you can see from here.
I like the clock, too.
Yep.
Oh, definitely.
And then the cure for your cotton mouth here.
And I mean, unbelievable variety of hookahs. What?
Yeah, this is fun. This is a fun one.
Yes, it is fun.
Good idea for the little stools, too.
Okay, our next stop is by Jameson, and it's the Shady Lady.
Shady Lady.
And
hey, should we give away another snail?
Sure.
Yes. I got an outfit for here, too.
You know the drill, my peeps. Exclamation point DTC.
I really like the story that he told for this one. This was a failed Methosian colony, and the jungle has pretty much reclaimed everything else except for this tavern. And all I gotta say is this: the architecture on this building is just... wow. Wow.
Yeah, and you're totally right. The description just adds another layer of coolness to it. But yeah, the architecture on this one. Awesome.
I mean, if you go... I went and I actually made a new character, and I was looking around, and it was a guardian. And I was looking around at the buildings that are in the Methosian area where you start out, and these are actually really close to those. I mean, you can't do an exact copy, but the style is definitely there.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of architecture, and this is cool.
Yeah. Well, Jameson has, I think this might be number 6, maybe number, I think it's number 6 on his builds, and he's always done some really strong architectural work, and I really enjoy his builds, and I really enjoyed this one too.
And Bridget has won our second snail giveaway.
Congratulations.
Is that Bridgit?
An extra T on the end. And 1111.
Okay, congrats, Bridget. 1111.
Oh, and you can smoke in this bar, which is really nice. These are big cigarettes.
Yeah, I don't even want to think about how much of a pain it was to line these limestone tiles up over this the pre-made wall to try to get that brickwork just right. To give it that appearance of being just a little bit in disrepair.
Yep.
I think this is your 99 bottles of beer, though.
Definitely. Let's break one of those open. Or two.
Yep. And this, especially after the last two, this one has a very definite change of pace.
Yep, definitely a different feel.
Get 100 dimension nerds, get 100 totally different dimensions.
For sure. And run into the wall. And all the rooms here are definitely different. I'm not going to lie, I don't know a lot about RP, but I could see there being some of the RP elements that would like to hang out in this place too, depending on whatever story they were playing.
Well, Diva knows about ERP, so you could tell us.
Hey, you know, there was another game that I tried RP in a couple times, and it usually wound up with me naked in Ironforge, and so I just stopped.
Oh, that's too funny.
We don't have an Ironforge here, but otherwise...
I know. But I've been emotionally scarred.
Just more Red Bull and vodka. That's all you need.
Yep.
This is an amazing looking building from the outside and the inside.
It is. I really...
Yep.
I really like that house. And more than Mythosian, it looks really Tudor-ish. Is that a word?
Yep. Yep.
Okay, our next one is Shaken Not Stirred by Zambo.
Zambo is in our guild.
Yep, this one had a lot of interesting elements.
Yep. Nice open feeling over the ocean.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get on that elevator. Hi, Diva. Uh-oh.
Gotta love an open air elevator.
Yeah, this looks like an old, not a good area if you're a sailor.
You went swimming?
Yeah, I'm in the water.
She fell in.
And I are looking for drinks.
I did not
fall
in. I jumped in. And I missed my ride.
Yeah, I just jumped in too. It was totally on purpose. It wasn't an accident at all. I jumped in.
You do need to be careful when you're drinking in this bar, because you may end up in the water.
Yeah.
Unless you're an expert fisherman like me, and then you won't.
Crap, I didn't time my
drink. I already drank all your beer.
Oh, that's fine. I don't like beer.
Okay. More for me.
There we go. Made it that time. Hey,
there's
Nico.
I like this guy in the bubble here. Yeah, he already gave me 5 glasses.
Yeah, I thought that the concept behind this one was really different, interesting. I like the mixing of the corals with the glass building blocks.
Yep. Good job, Zambo. I think he's on here, maybe. Maybe not.
And this is a really small build too, isn't it? It's only like 300 items, 300 and some items.
Yeah, yeah, 366. It's at T2.
And so now we're off to the Majestic by Rainastar.
Here we are.
Yep, this one also had a lot of interesting concepts and some really good ideas. I do like this... the ticket booth. Oh, there's Nico.
Oh, thank goodness.
What I really like is that Rainastar set up these the lantern strings as cups. Oh, that was just a great idea.
Temple of the Abandoned is one of the probably not as commonly used dimensions.
Not it is. And I like using these Eth shrines as the bar counter thingy. You know, that thing. That's a technical term.
The bar?
Yeah. I said the bar thingy.
The bar thingy, you know what she meant. This is a long run up here, Diva. I hope
I gotta get my steps in for the day.
Oh, thank goodness there's a Nico up here.
Do you like this sign? This matches the sign that's up front, of course.
I like that, using the banner for the AM, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
We got a little DJ here.
Yeah.
Here's some more toilets, Diva.
Uh-oh. I missed those. Oh, yep.
And see, you can get in there.
Yeah, you can fit. Need a hell all jig ball in here.
No.
Yeah.
No.
I need to sell mine. Those things are worth a lot.
Another thing I really like was Rainastar using the music boxes inset into the wall, but not all the way.
Yeah, I love pattern on their underside.
Yeah, and then this instance, she's using the sides also, the green and purple.
Oh yeah, along the stairs.
Along the stairs, and then also around that mm-hmm. big pole in the middle.
Oh yeah, that's very pretty.
What are you gonna do with all those music boxes?
Yeah, use them as decor items, like this.
Now you know. I should build a house out of one.
You heard it here first, folks.
I don't know which song that's playing, though.
Okay, and the that's going to do it for Fablite, which had a really good showing this time. And we're off to Greybriar.
Good job, Fablite.
That sounds like it should be time for 5 more bags, right?
Okay, cool. Here we go with exclamation point DTC. Type it in again, everybody.
Now, can you say the name of this gem, Fiendish?
Animaeus?
Yeah.
Hold on, I've got stuck on a loading screen. No.
Me neither.
Tatua. That's what I'm calling it.
Yeah, if you can't pronounce it, you just say it real fast. Blah, blah, blah. I think you have to jump in this one, don't you?
Oh, yeah. This is definitely your space age place.
Yeah, this one is definitely sci-fi.
And the winner is Kinnereth FB.
Good job, Kinnereth. She's on the Fablite.
Yep. Now, I want to say he's K-I-N-N-E-R-E-T-H or O-R.
What did she win, by the way?
It's 5 Corvin bags.
5 Corvin bags.
Cool. Like my mohawk? That's what I look like in real life.
So I do like this take on being enclosed. Using the storage buildings and orb displays and cosmic trees to make a space vibe out here.
Yeah, that's cool. I recognize that too. It's just kind of fun to come in here and look around. Nice depth perception.
And we've got some more architect stuff.
Love this cool lettering at the entrance. These symbols and stuff.
Yeah, and this is another one where it's like 3 spring.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's a great transformation.
Love this decoration on the floor.
I love this one. Is one where I love how there's the whole subfloor underneath. That's cool.
Yeah, she made a lot of interesting morphs here, and Animea, she's up to what now, Diva? 30?
A lot. Yeah.
In the 30s?
More, I think. High in the 30s.
Yeah, cool art. Cool wall art stuff.
Yeah, cool Nico. Furniture.
Oh, thank goodness.
Lots of cool again. Stuff in here. Yeah, it's been almost 4 minutes since your last drink.
Hey, all I need to know is where the bathroom is.
It's around here somewhere. Oh, there's another Nico over here.
Oh, perfect.
And I do really like her DJ setup over here with her little alien guy.
Yeah, that's cool.
And his headphones.
I like the...
Yeah.
I'm not sure if he's flipping Diva the bird or showing me a peace sign. I think he's flipping Diva the bird.
Probably.
I think I'm flipping somebody the bird.
And I like this thing over here. This just has like a cool feeling. Some pool up here, some space pool.
So much awesome detail.
And the way that these water blocks end up reflecting different kinds of light is really cool effect too.
Yep. You took the short way down.
Yes, I did. Twice. It's just a great concept going on here. And boy, this aquatic stuff really stands out against the solid black background.
Oh, Dancing with Diva. Gotta do our RP.
That's an insult to role-playing Kula.
Yeah, I figured I'd get myself in trouble somehow.
Well, I've moved on to the hen house. By Odentia. And he's another prolific builder. I think he's up to 20-something.
This is another one that has that little town-ish, town-esque feel to it.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah.
A city-type area here.
I noticed the water, the reflection, those tiles on where the bar is back here is really cool. Look, has a neat effect.
Yeah, things like ponds tend to reflect a sky without recognizing a projector, but I think the building blocks recognize a sky projector, so they actually reflect the what you're actually showing. Like his sign here has a little hen on it. We got just all kinds of activity going on in here.
Yeah, this place has all kinds of things to do. Little punching bag here. Little shuffleboard area over here.
And your Nico.
And then another Nico. Can't have too many of those.
I I guess you feel pretty safe when you live in the neighborhood where the guard bar is.
Yeah, as long as they're not drinking on the job. Like somebody else we know.
I don't know who you're talking about. I might get up here and sing, though.
I know. And this guy, Orfeel, he really gets around, too. He's just an all-around funny guy.
I'm telling you. Ship's captain.
Bartender.
Lead singer. Yeah.
Many roles. Uh-oh.
Muriel, better look out. She's going to be out of work.
Do you like his little band set up over here?
Yeah, a lot of work.
Yep. Definitely a lot of effort went into this one.
Was this the person you were saying doesn't use, like, the tools? I don't remember.
Yeah, he freehands. And then last
but... So that just adds even more.
Yeah. And then last but not least, Emerald, the Barley Brook Brewery. Say that drunk 10 times fast. And the only one that uses Stoneflask Tavern.
But doesn't use the built-in tavern.
Yeah, which is somewhere under one of these rocks.
I just love seeing that giant mountain on top of it.
Mm-hmm. And Emerald is coming back from a pretty significant break, so welcome back, Emerald. It's definitely good to see her building again.
Yeah, this has such a feel like where you would go do like some wine tasting or something. Totally has that.
Oh, yes, it does. Mm-hmm.
A lot of great details.
Yeah, the
here.
Roof on this
defense.
One.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, no, I was just going to point out just the roof curve the way it is just so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and
I love
little
this
barley
entrance banner.
Made.
Yeah.
Yeah, one of the things I liked about this one was that she used a lot of, like, banners and bunting and stuff, and instead of using the pre-existing carnival stuff, she went and made her own, like, you know, these little awnings, too.
So cute.
Yeah, that's cool. Good degree of creativity and technicality.
Yep, and Emerald has, I think, 12 or 13 dimensions, and she's got some on Fayblight, and some here. Most of them are here, but she's got, I think, 3 on Fayblight. And there's those morphed bunting.
Like the little dartboard here.
Yeah, the dartboard. This whole little cabinet area over here with the gourd and the pie and.
You know, the other thing that I think is just stands out kind of cool, and I don't know why, but just having the chairs up on the wall like that.
Yeah, it's a good detail.
Yeah, very good.
And the little board. The little board with the little things pinned onto it. That's pretty cool. It's different.
A bulletin board?
Oh, a bulletin board. Too many drinks for me. Is that what you call it?
Yeah, that's even the technical term. I really like the still.
Oh yeah, the still is great. Yeah, this is another one that's really cool.
Yeah.
Can you say the Barley Brook Brewery three times really fast?
No.
Come on, Fiendish.
I can't even say it three times really slow. So this is the last one on our tour today. I want to thank you, Kula, for coming with us, but we're not quite done yet, are we, Diva? I think we still have another snail.
Yep, we got one more snail.
And thank you guys for having me on here and doing this off-week contest run-through. I appreciate it.
Well, hey, thank you for
it was a lot of fun.
Sponsoring the contest. Yeah.
Yes, thank you so much. Okay, peeps, here comes the last snail, so if you want a chance at it, exclamation point DTC, please. If somebody who's already won a snail wins, we'd go to the next winner.
I'm showing Diva the special outfit I made just for her.
Uh-oh, I might need to leave you guys alone.
I want Queen Myella's outfit so bad.
You must have a thong of every color in your wardrobe cabinet.
Maybe.
That much butt cheek is illegal in some states.
It is.
Very color coordinated. Somebody suggested that you need to dye that black, Fiendish, and tell me that it's made from gravy boats.
Yeah, that's a fantastic idea.
Okay, any other people need to enter exclamation point DTC? This is a giveaway for the last snail. I think our snail coffers are bare after this one, too. Who knows if we'll ever get more? Okay, here's my drum roll.
Wow.
Boo won it! Congratulations,
Boo! Congrats. That's a V
awesome,
with three
Boo.
O's, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
All right. Well, thank you for staying with us for the long haul today, and we will see you next week from the Shard of Lathis, where we'll be on with Marnth. and looking at doodles and having a good time.
A lot of fun stuff next week, too.
Yep.
Thank you again, Kula.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks for having me. Have a great Mother's Day. Take care.
Oh, you stole
thank
my
you,
mind.
Everybody who joined us today.
Yep. Have a great weekend.